The ICBI, the Nippon Foundation Mathematics Package for Teachers. Title of the video, De Morgan's Law on Set Difference. Let us prove A minus B intersection C equals A minus B union A minus C. Now we have to prove this equation, and for that we need three sets. Let us take three sets A with three elements 1, 2 and 3. Now let us have B with three elements 3, 4 and 5. C has three elements 2, 6 and 7. Now we have to prove that A minus B and A minus C and take their union. Let us take A minus B. So let us consider sets A and B. So what is A minus B? The elements of A which are not in B. So what is A minus B? The elements of A which are not in set B. What are they? 1, 2, 3 in set A, set B 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2 are missing. So A minus B is consisting of 1 and 2. Let us take A minus C. A minus C, consider A and C. A has 1, 2, 3. C has 2, 6, 7. So that means A minus C is the objects in A which are not found in C. That means which objects are not found in C? 2 is found in C. 1 and 3 are not found in C. So A minus C becomes 1 and 3. Now we have found out the A minus B and A minus C. Now we have to take the union of this. So what is A minus B union A minus C? We have to take the distinct objects of A minus B and A minus C. Now look at the objects 1, 2 and 1, 3. So 1 should not be repeated. You have to take one category, but that should not be repeated. Now 2 and 3. So that means we have to take 1, 2 and 3. So that becomes A minus B union A minus C. Right? Now we have to find out B intersection C. Now what is B intersection C? Now B has 3, 4, 5 and C has 2, 6, 7. Well, there is no common objects. That means B intersection C is nothing. It's nothing. So A minus B intersection C, A minus B intersection C is A minus B intersection C has 1, 2, 3. Now A minus B union A minus C is 1, 2, 3. That means A minus B intersection C equals A minus B union A minus C. Right. Now let us take another example. Let us have four numbers in set A. Set A has 1, 2, 3, 4. Let the set B have 4, 5, 6, 7. 6 and 7. Now let us have set C. Let us have the values of C as 3, 6, 8 and 9. So let us prove the De Morgan's law of set difference using this new set. A has 4 elements 1, 2, 3, 4. B has 4 elements 4, 5, 6, 7. C has 3 elements 3, 6, 8, 9. Let us find out A minus B. A minus B is nothing but the objects of A not found in B. Objects of A not found in B, what are they here? 1, 2, 3. Now let us go for A minus C. Look at the set A, 1, 2, 3, 4. and C is 3689. 3 is the only element of A found in C. That means the remaining values are 1, 2 and 4. This is A minus C. Now we have to take A minus B union A minus C. So that is, you have to take all the distinct objects. So 1 is common, so you just take 1. There is no repetition necessary. 2 is common, so you just take 2. There is no repetition necessary. 3 is not repeated and 4 is not repeated. So you take 3 and 4. So A minus B union A minus C becomes 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. Now let us go for B intersection C. What is B intersection C? 4, 5, 6, 7, 3, 6, 8, 9. So what is common between B and C? Only one element, that is 6. Now what is A minus B intersection C? So that means objects of A which are not found in B intersection C. Well, all the four elements are not found in B intersection C. B intersection C has only 6. So the A minus B intersection C has 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now compare the results. A minus B union A minus C. It has 1, 2, 3, 4. A minus B intersection C has 1, 2, 3, 4. So that means we have proved the De Morgan's law of set difference, which says that A minus B intersection C equals A minus B union A minus C. I'm sure with this kind of experience, the child will be able to understand the De Morgan's law of set difference.